thank you very much for having me this evening, and to Gina and Suzanne, it's great to be here. I have many friends in this room. Just a little bit of a thumbnail sketch of me. Again, Mike Hogan. I grew up in Pearl River. My family moved from the Bronx to Pearl River in 1953. Some of you may be familiar with this very interesting little community we had up there. A couple of old timers, I remember a place called Marycrest. And my family was a founding member of Marycrest. And just a little point of interest, Dorothy Day visited us in Marycrest years ago. Very proud, but a very progressive community. My dad was a civil rights advocate. Went to the, I'll never forget, 4 o'clock in the morning, he came into my room, knocked on the door, and said, "Michael, would you like to come with me today?" I go, "Where are you going, Dad?" He goes, "I'm going to Washington." I said, "What are you doing?" He says, they were having a rally in Washington. That was the August 1963, and it was the famous march in Washington, and the famous Martin Luther King, "I Have a Dream." My dad went, I had to work with Uncle Luke, so I wasn't there. I regret that to this day. But from my very young age, I've been involved in civil rights, all kinds of different progressive activities. In fact, although I went to a military high school in New York, the same high school that Antonin Scalia went to, by the way, and I'm not proud of that, and Wilbur Gross. I went to college in Mobile, Alabama, because I was interested in civil rights. I went to Spring Hill College, a small Jesuit college in Mobile. After a stint in the Army, I returned to Mobile. I taught school in Mobile. I won't tell you the whole history over a beer sometime, maybe, but I stayed in Alabama for a while. I got my doctorate at the University of Alabama, so if you see this guy running around with roll tie shirts, that's me. I worked for the governor. I learned a lot about politics working with the governor. I was active in the NEA prior to that. Then I was on the other side as a part of the governor's policy team. Knew George Wallace. Didn't work for George Wallace, I worked for a guy named Forrest James. But again, then from there, I moved on to Colorado, where I was a finance director of a school district, deputy superintendent of schools in Colorado Springs, superintendent of schools in Farmington, New Mexico. Through about the late 90s. In the late 90s, I came back to New York and I went to work at Long Island University. Some of you may know my wife, Nancy Lowe Hogan, in the Rockland County Legislature, former council person in Orangetown. And she and I have put our heads together for a number of years now in terms of Rockland County politics, state politics, national politics as well. So I've been involved with politics, especially since 2004 when Rockland County did not show the power and vigor it needed to get behind John Kerry. That was very disappointing, and Nancy and I rose up. Some of you may remember, Nancy actually ran for the state Senate right after that against Tom Morahan. When the Democrats, by the way, all wanted to cross-endorse Mr. Morahan, we said no. We've got to have somebody who stands with every guy. Tom was a good guy, no question about it. But, we stand for things. We stand for Democratic values.
He was very good at getting his daughter's jobs.
What's that?
He was very good at getting his daughter's jobs.
Yes. So, I've been involved with the Orangetown Committee. I'm the vice chair. I've been the vice chair for a number of years. I'm on the executive committee, the Rockland Democratic Committee, on the corresponding secretary. I don't do a lot of corresponding, but I'm on that committee. And for about 6 years, I've been interested in the New York State Democratic Committee. I believe that is part of the hierarchy of influence in policy in New York. Right now, in my opinion, it does not have the influence it should have. We should be bringing to Albany in that committee and sharing amongst our colleagues around the state our ideas, what's important to us. What's important to Mike Hogan? Campaign finance reform. Too much special interest money in our politics. You look at Mr. Carlucci's records. You look at the IBC finance records. You look at any of those characters who are voting against progressive legislation, and you see where the money is coming from. in the hundreds of thousands of dollars, millions of dollars, and we have to do something about that. That is, to me, and I carry this around as a prop, how democracies die. They die when we kill our system, when we take the voices away from you and me and give it to a few people with a lot of money. They're killing the state of New York. It took me 2 hours to get here tonight from my job. Why? Because the infrastructure in New York stinks. Why? Because it's not a priority. It's a priority for you and I to get on those highways, but we're not the movers and shakers. We've got to have, and we've got to take care, you know, this is controversial in Rockland County, but we've got to take care of the MTA. Why? Because New York City is the lifeblood of the state of New York. And we have to make sure that that institution is funded and not used as a political pawn. We have to clean up our election laws in this state. It is outrageous that all we have is the Tuesday, the first Tuesday in November, in November, and this ridiculous primary registration. We should have early voting, postcard registration, online registration. The chance of fraud as it relates to public participation is absolutely, practically non-existent. And the people who will tell you that it isn't usually initials like DT. We've got to get more participation in our democracy, and that means giving people the opportunity to vote and encourage them to vote. So we need that. We need infrastructure reform. We need campaign finance reform. We need school finance reform in this state. We are not giving the resources to the schools with the highest need children in our state, ELL children and children of poverty. We are not giving them the resources to find and retain the best teachers and best principals. It is, I've worked with schools for over 40 years. I've worked with high need schools in New York, and it is a disgrace. And again, East Ramapo has a very large number of high need students. They need resources, not a million here and a million there. That is just eye candy. That isn't the way the structural reform needs to take place. New York State Democratic Committee, another voice in the room.